Okay guys, welcome to another That Was Year That Was. Now this has been the first one for a long, long time. So apologies about the sort of delay in this one coming. Excuse me. Yep, 1994. Dearie me, where did the time go? It just seems like yesterday. Anyway, what are we doing? Chart-wise in the UK, let's have a look. The top 10. In number 10 we had Ace of Base with The Sign. Don't remember that one. Number 9, oh dearie me, Manchester United Football Squad, Come On You Reds. Yep, number 8, Let Loose, dearie me, Crazy For You. Number 7, Mariah Carey with Without You. 6 was Bon Jovi, Always. Number 5 is Dereem, and it's pretty much appropriate here, Things Can Only Get Better. Number 4 was Pat O'Banton, Baby Come Back. 3 was All For One, I Swear. Don't remember that one. No, I do. That was another boy band, I think. Number 2, Lest We Forget, was the awful Wigfield Saturday Night. And number 1 was the Glasgow Scottish band Wet, 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 which, looking out the window, is quite appropriate with Love Is All Around. Now, that was a song which was number 1 for about 4.5 years. So, yeah, anyway, let's see, news-wise, what was happening in 1994. World events, let's see, the Serbs, heavy weapons, pound Sarajevo, so no change there. The IRA declared a ceasefire in Northern Ireland on August the 31st. US events, Olympic figure skater Nancy Kerrigan was attacked and 3 were arrested. I'm sure there was another skater was actually found guilty of attacking her. Major League Baseball players strike on August the 13th. Now this seems to be very USA biased. Entertainment, if that's the right word to use for this one. Kurt Cobain killed himself, he was only 27. 95 million viewers watch O.J. Simpson and Al Cowling's drive along the Los Angeles freeway in history's most exciting low-speed chase. Steven Spielberg won his first directing Oscar for Schindler's List. And Tom Hanks won his second Best Actor for his 1993 portrayal of Philadelphia, and also 1994 for Forrest Gump. Yep, the big movies were Forrest Gump, Pulp Fiction, Shawshank Redemption, Quiz Show and Nobody's Fool. And in that year, people of note who died were Richard Nixon, Cab Calloway, Burt Lancaster, now a favourite of mine is John Candy, and Jacqueline Onassis. So yeah, that was the news in 1994. So anyway, enough about that. Let's move on to stuff way more important. And it's video games. Now this game here is called 1000 Miglia. What's it called? 1000 Miglia Great Race or something, I think it is. I'm sure this was a Neo Geo game? Possibly not. Okay, the first game we're going to look at, guys, is 1000 Miglia, whatever it's called. I'm guessing that's some sort of race, is it? Some proper race? I'm not too sure. So anyway, let's crack on and see what the fuss is about. Ready? 3, 2, 1, go. Now, I can actually remember seeing this in a local pub, but by that point I'd kind of lost interest in arcade games, you know. Whoops. My era was always going to be the classic games and stuff like this. Just, I don't know, we could play games like this on our home computer, so it just felt meh. But looking at this game now, it's actually a really, really nice game. Some nice meaty kind of engine effects. After the rock wall, let's go for another shot. It's got a really nice impression of speed. You can see the wee bits in the road sort of fly past really, really quick, which kind of really, really adds to the overall effect. Now I'm doing completely shite here. And the fact that I'm playing this at a sort of a 3-inch by 4-inch window is probably not helping. Ah, bollocks. Anyway guys, listen, yep, that's 1,000 Miglia. Okay, this is Aero Fighters. And this was actually a Neo Geo game. This was Aero Fighters 2, I beg your pardon. A rather natty shoot 'em up. What will we go for? We shall go for a dolphin with a helmet. Yep, he is the world's first dolphin pilot. That's the thing about the wacky Japanese, they come up with these really bizarre sort of sub-stories, even though the games themselves are excellent. I mean, what a dolphin has got to do with a game like this, I have no idea. But I've played these Aero Fighters games quite a lot. I'm sure they... did they get ported to some other console? I think they may have done, but really, really good example of a vertical shooter. Excellent graphics, really nice detail. Oops. And there's power-ups aplenty. What the hell is that? No, that's got to be only one thing. It's our end of level guardian. Holy moly. Ah, bollocks! But this is certainly worthy of your attention. It's good night, Vienna. I never thought I'd be flying over a jungle. Keep your silly humour to yourself, thank you very much. If anybody that watches my videos, you'll know that I'm not a big fan of the sort of the energy type, sort of power up type shooters. I'm more a sort of one hit and you're dead type person. But I've got to say, you know, this is such a joy to play. You know, you see me get power ups all the time, but it's such a nice looking game. It really is. Oh, your signal's another badass. I mean, shoot 'em ups by this point, they're really getting done on an epic scale, and, you know, the sort of home machines couldn't handle stuff like this. Well, saying that, stuff like the Mega Drive and the SNES probably could, but home computers were struggling to do stuff like this. I mean, the Amiga gave it a good attempt, but it never quite reached the sort of heights of stuff like this. But anyway, listen, that's Aero Fighters 2. Okay, this is Primal Rage even, and this was released by Atari. I'm guessing it must have been one of the sort of the more final games released by Atari. And just for a change, it's a one-on-one beat-em-up. Now, if I remember rightly, I'm sure this game featured in Games Master, and I'm sure this monkey actually does a piss at the end. This was really at the point when companies thought that the customer just wanted better and better and better graphics. So you can see here, I think they were using stop animation or something, stop play animation, whatever it was. I mean, the graphics looked really nice, but, you know, what they didn't realise is we just wanted good games rather than complete, you know, multiple beat-em-ups and God knows what with little sort of thought or, you know, ingenuity. That was possibly just my opinion anyway, but I certainly couldn't be asked for games like this. What's he going to do? He's going to do nothing. Yeah, it almost feels to me like the companies, they had just concentrated more on, you know, graphics and that kind of stuff, and they'd actually forgot to put in any gameplay. I mean, how many beat-em-ups does anyone want to actually play? Is he going to piss on him? Ah, he's not. Domination. I appear to be uppercutting the people who are watching. Well, they shouldn't be bloody standing quite so close. And it's all over. Right, yeah, that's that one. That's Primal Rage, and that was by Atari Games. Okay, this is Alien vs Predator.
Time to hunt.
And who made this? Was this Capcom? I'm not quite sure. I can't really tell because for some reason when I open up a meme window, the actual sort of list disappears. But anyway. Here we start.
Select your click lane.
Who shall we go? Let's go. Let's go to Predator.
Round one.
And by this point, they had really, really honed the sort of graphics of these sideways scrollers. I mean, you know, you just can't fault it. Beautiful looking. Now I think this game, well, you can see there it says press start, so I'm guessing you could have at least two players playing this game. You've got Super Magazine, right, okay, whatever. I don't believe I ever saw this on any home system. That was too easy. Maybe me, what on earth is that? Despite the absolutely gorgeous visuals in these games, I always find them a bit... You can almost play them with your eyes closed. You know, you just hit the button as quick as you can. I'm not going to say there's no real skill involved, because I'm sure there is, but they're not really my type of game. But, you know, they're certainly the kind of games that would get people putting money in, because it just looks really nice. Ah, take that. And again. Of whatever that's called. It's basically Final Fight with aliens and predators. I mean, these games were as They were just, there were tons and tons of them. It's almost like every single possible character you could get, there was a game, a sideways scrolling game. Yeah, anyway, listen guys, that is Alien vs Predator. Hey, this is Art of Fighting by SNK, or sorry, Art of Fighting 2 I should say. Beat-em-ups by this point were absolutely paying a penny. And as much as I don't really like beat-em-ups, I do quite like Street Fighter. I mean, I can't play it to save myself, but I do enjoy playing it, but obviously the sort of Neo Geo beat-em-ups just look too sterile. I don't know what it was, maybe a bit too realistic, I'm not too sure. I mean, there's no question of it, they're amazing looking games, and you can see where the game sort of scrolls in and out, and zooms in and out. Probably technically it's better than a Street Fighter game. Famous beat-em-up in the Neo Geo, they probably became a fighter or something. I think that was, you know, I think they were up to something like King of Fighters 10 or something. They were bringing it out. In fact, they weren't called 10, they were called King of Fighters 2006. There were a lot of versions of that. Yep, anyway guys, that's King of, so that's Art of Fighting 2, and that was by Neo Geo. Okay, this is BC Kid. Does it tell you who made it? It doesn't actually. PC Kid or Bonk's Adventure as it was called. Now this game did originate, I believe, on the PC Engine. It's a sideways scrolling platformer with this little dude BC Kid he's called. And the way he kills baddies is he basically, whoops, a daisy, he basically puts a head in them. So I guess there could have been a market for a version called Glasgow Kiss. Now I have played the PC Engine one before, and this kind of differs in layout from it. Whoops. Oh, there we go. Yep, he's also, if he eats a particular, I don't know what it is, if he eats a particular thing, he turns into a rather sort of nasty little character, and he can basically kill anything in his path. But it's a great little platform game, it really is. Didn't actually realise that this was released as an arcade game. Okay, anyway, that's enough of that one. That is BC Kid. Okay, this is Battletoads. Now this is a game released by Rare. Now I believe it actually came out on a home console before. So it's quite surprising to see this in the arcades. Now do we have two players to start? Now Battletoads was obviously quite a big sort of license back in the day. The visuals are really nice. Never actually played this before, never even seen it before. Yeah, this is certainly a lovely looking game. Again, I don't think this particular version ever came out on any home system. Toad, I should say. take that. Yeah, these sideways scrolling beat 'em ups were very much popular at this point in time. It seemed that the public just couldn't get enough of them. Where's plutonium? I can take that. Just pick that up. There we go. So there's it. I quite like this sort of out of camera kind of view. Eat the flies. Arge! Right, anyway, listen, that's enough of that one. That is battle to us. Okay, this is Cruise in USA. Now, this game was released by Midway, and rather oddly, it was actually produced or directed by the maker of my favourite game ever, which is Robotron 2084, and that was Eugene Jarvis. It just seemed such a sort of departure from what he would normally do, but I guess things had moved on. People didn't want sprite-based shooters, so they had to obviously look to see where they could go from here. So anyway, cruising USA. Try saying that when you've had a drink. Now I'm using a gamepad here to try and steer, so it's probably going to be pretty awful. Come on, how'd I move? What did I pick? I picked manual gears. It would obviously not control this badly if I was using a mouse or a steering wheel or something, so apologies now in advance. Yeah, I mean, it looks alright. The problem is, I think, driving games in particular have moved on so much in the last sort of 20 years. I mean, you know, we're now playing games like Drive Club and Project Cars, and they just look completely realistic. So when you look at games like this with kind of pop-up and sort of quite basic polygons, they look pretty dated. But back in 1994, this was probably cutting edge. Whoops, a daisy. Yeah, using an analogue stick is absolutely hopeless. It's just impossible to actually go in a straight line. Yeah, it kind of reminds me very much of an N64 game. Possible because the game it reminds me of is Cruising USA, so go figure. But this is the kind of games where people were just wanting to be blown away with graphics, and so companies catered for the public and put out stuff like this. Yeah, anyway, that's enough of that one, guys. That's Cruise in USA. It was by Midway. Okay, this is Darius Gaydon, and this was by Tato, I believe. And Darius is also a long time running sort of franchise. Of the sort of horizontally shoot type shoot 'em ups. I think this game saw release on the PC Engine. He doesn't want to die. But it's a really, really, really pretty shoot 'em up, and this is the kind of game that I love. Really spoiled for games in this kind of type. But yeah, there's quite a few Darius games released including one that I think we looked at earlier. It's a, it was like any like a four screen affair. It was really, really sort of long and narrow. Oops, I did. This game seems to have a lot of references to kind of fish type things, different creatures. He's going back. Oh, excuse me. Dearie me. Beg your pardon. Comes a badass, a huge battleship, Golden Ogre. Oh dear me. Yep, it's fish-like. He's going to make a charge, isn't he? Sure, he's got an energy bar or something. Ah, dear me. And he's gone. So it's a bit trippy and happy. Yeah, anyway guys, that's Daddy's Gaiden. Okay, this is Darkstalkers, The Night Warriors. This is by Capcom. Do we go mummy, do we go bird, do we go a guy with a traffic cone on his head? Let's go for Sasquatch. I was actually going to say Sasquatch before I realised that we're fighting in England apparently. There's no doubt going to be Big Ben. Now, as I was scrolling through the list of games made in 1994, this one did jump out. Not literally, but the name of it, so I'm sure it must have saw a release of some sort. But I guess any Capcom beat 'em up is always going to be pretty popular. You know, compared to even stuff like Street Fighter, you can really see just how gorgeous the animation and artwork of these games, you know, had become really well. And I'm guessing these were all hand-drawn back in the day. But like most beat-em-ups, I've got absolutely no idea what I'm doing, so I'm just basically mashing the buttons as quick as I possibly can. And I've just had my arse handed to me on a plate. Yeah, that's Darkstalkers, The Night Warriors. And that was by Capcom. Okay, this is Elevator Action Returns. And this was again by Taito. Now this was the first Elevator Action was a very, very early video game. So, never seen this one before. Select your character. Card Bradfield. Jad the Taff. Let's go for Jad the Taff. Edie Barrett. Okay, mission one. Take the information off the place bombs are set. Rather strange place to put a new line, but anyway. All the words together. Okay, right. Interesting. Like I said, I've never ever seen this. Oh, dearie me, I'm going to die for sure.
Now, the first game was obviously very similar. It was elevator related, but it featured sort of far more kind of cartoony type graphics. This is certainly a lot. Oh, dearie me, kill dogs. Lucky enough they don't actually. That was, why did I do that? Yeah, it's obviously far dirtier and violent looking. Obviously set after the apocalypse, I'm guessing. Kill the dog. It's a very, very nicely animated game. Crush the old order. Who dug it? Yeah, there we go. I think the idea of this game was to get to the bottom level or something, I think. Is it going to go down? Doesn't look like it. That was going to happen, didn't we? Hey, come on, why is that not going down? Ouch. I've got to say, I'm rather impressed with this game. I mean, I'm playing it in a really, really wee window, so I can't really fully appreciate. Right, it doesn't. I'm guessing I can't actually go down any further. Ah, oh, is it maybe the one at the end? I'm not quite sure. Let's try the one at the end. But this is actually really, really nice. Ah, bollocks. Right, I'm really not quite sure what I need to do. Anyway, listen, I've probably played this one long enough, but that's excellent. That's Elevator Action Returns, and that was released by Tato. Again, I don't think that saw a release on any home system. Hey, this is a game called, what was it called? I don't actually know the name of the game. It's by a company called
Genix Family.
There we go, Genix Family, and it was released by a company called Genix, I believe. Now, basically what this is, by the looks of things, it's a pretty nice start, and it's got the most horrendous looking characters ever. This is quite clearly a completely shameless rip-off of Pang. To see that ripping other companies off was alive and kicking in 1994. Yeah, it's probably got about the most unlovable kind of characters you can actually think of. They're not endearing in the slightest. I've got to say, it's not a bad game, but then, you know what? They're just copying Pang and doing their own version of it. But I think I would be safe to say that this game wasn't released for anything. I mean, Pang was released for a lot of systems. Yeah, listen, I've seen enough of that one. That is whatever it's called. It's not well very done. Good. Okay, this is called the Max and the Jewel. I'm guessing. What is this? Beat 'em up. and this was released by, is it Sega or something they're called? I can't remember exactly. It says, I can't see the information, unfortunately. Soon find out. By Psycho. Is that how you pronounce it? I'm not too sure. This is actually an excellent game, and it has indeed been ported to a few systems over the years. And if you like your vertical shooters like me, you'll love this game. There was a sequel released later on. It's a beautiful example of a vertical shooter done with double proper. Get something at my door, I'm busy. I couldn't see if it was, but it didn't really mean. This game is such a joy to play. It's typically a manga. The graphics, the overall presentation is just absolutely glorious. I don't know what it could do, it still plays a mean game. Ah, bollocks, I'm going in to try and pick up my power-ups. Greed was my undoing. I'm going to have another shot of that. But it's such a good game. Yeah, this, I'm sure, well, it came out of the Dreamcast for sure. I think it may have also been released on PlayStation 2, I'm not really sure. Oh! Anyway, listen, that's enough of that one. That's Gunbird, and that's by Psycho. Okay, this is, excuse me, this is Jurassic Park. And I think this was... Good luck. Was it Sega, I think it was? This is rather appropriate, a game, given the latest one has just been released in the cinema. I went to see it last. Get a good shoot. Okay, this is Jurassic Park, and this was released by Sega.
Good luck.
Start it. Now, this was one of these big sort of gun-type games. I'm sure it came in a sort of you're sitting in one of the kind of vehicle-type things with a big, massive screen. It's obviously quite a relevant game at the moment, given the shoot in the head. Given that the latest film has just been released in the cinema, I actually went to see it a couple of weeks ago. Everybody I know really enjoyed it. I wasn't overly impressed with what it was. But anyway, I'm not going to spoil it. I certainly wouldn't say don't go and see it, because all my mates thought it was excellent. I was maybe just expecting a bit more. This game is pretty great for anything. Polygon City. Oh shit. Yeah, this is one of these games that really relied on the sort of size of screen and the sort of visuals. It's quite a simplistic game, but I'm sure on a big massive screen it can be done quite nice. But anyway, yep, that's enough of that one guys, that is Jurassic Park. Okay, this is Mortal Kombat 3, and that was by Midway. This game needs very little introduction, if any. It was ported to pretty much every machine known to man, I think. Did it come out in the 8-bit machines? I don't think so. I think by 1994, the 8-bit machines had pretty much died a death, but it did come out in the Amiga, I think, and Atari ST, and it certainly came out on the Mega Drive, sort of the other consoles. And also the PlayStation 2, PlayStation 1, and if I remember rightly, it was a particularly good version. Okay. Now, I always preferred Mortal Kombat to play over Street Fighter, I think, just because it was probably a bit easier. It was easier to pull off special moves and that kind of stuff. Oddly, the sound in this is very low. I'm not quite sure what's going on there. But this game is obviously famed for the amount of gore, and in particular the sort of the finishing moves where people had their heads ripped off, spines removed, eyes gouged out. Apparently, well, there's a new version that's just been released. Well, it's been released for a few months, and apparently the sort of gore has just been ramped up 100%. But it is actually a nice game to play. I don't say it's easy, but it's certainly easier to master than something like Street Fighter 2. Come on, special move. Ah, we're not going to see one. Let's go for one more go. But it'd certainly improved the sort of digitised pictures or graphics. The original one looks a bit rubbish compared to, you know, the second and the third one. But I'm sure it had more frames animation in it as well, which made it look really, really nice. I'm getting absolutely creamed here, as expected. And I'm sure this particular one brought in a thing rather than a finishing move, a death move. You could actually do a friendship move where you gave somebody like a birthday cake or a present. It all got a bit silly. One special move. Nah, we're not going to see one. Anyway, listen guys, that's enough of that one. That is Mortal Kombat 3, and that was by Midway. Okay, this is Panic Bomber, and this was by released on the Neo Geo by SNK, I think it was. Now, I've never actually played this game before, I've heard of it. Right, now I am assuming I want to try and... Yeah. You want to try and put three of the same colour up. Now, what does the bomb do? I'm not quite sure what that does. That was a bit rubbish. Oh, dear me. Right, I'm doing absolutely pants here. Well, there's three blue ones. three right ones. Right, I'm not quite sure what happens to the bombs here. Power up. Okay, right, don't know what's going on here. Right. It's like Candy Crush and all these other godforsaken puzzle games. Oh dearie me. So we're actually competing against the computer, it would appear. Ah, that's game over. Right, okay, yeah, enough of that one. That is Panic Bomber. And that was by SNK. Okay, this is Point Blank, and this was released by Namco. I do remember seeing this came out on the PlayStation 1, and I can always remember seeing one of my mates playing it. I think he had the light gun, and it looked pretty funky. Very hard, training expert, no, let's just go for it. Okay, shoot 12. Criminals don't shoot these, right. Bullets feel unlimited. Dare it me. Oof, that was lucky. I was going to say lucky, it wasn't really actually. Oof. Now it's basically, it's a light gun game, but it's got a lot of little kind of mini games. And it's supposed to be a lot of fun to actually play. Shoot 12 targets, okay. Ah, right, so I've got unlimited bullets, so I'll be as well. Just hammering the fire button like I'm doing. Right, go for this one. Shoot one apple. How hard can that be? Alright, I've got one bullet. Oh, come on, that wasn't exactly what you call challenging. Shoot 12 bottles or more. Bullets unlimited, right, okay. Alright, I've only got 5 seconds. That's actually a lot of fun, that, you know. It really is. I'll say, that was just a training. Try the expert game. Right, anyway, listen, that's that one. That's excellent. That is Point Blank, and that was released by Namco. And it says that you can actually get it for the PlayStation 1. If you've got a light gun in CRT TV, then go check it out now. Okay, this is Puzzle Bobble. And I think, is this by Tato, I think it is? Yeah, of course it is. It's the same people that made Bubble Bobble. This game is quite a delightful little puzzle game. It's obviously featuring the sprites from Bubble Bobble, but they've turned into a sort of puzzle game where you need to try and fire bubbles to link up with similar coloured ones. It's got some of the most cutesy sound effects you'll ever hear. It's just stupidly cute. And the idea is to basically clear the screen like so. As you can probably tell, you get the wee guiding line for the first sort of the first level. Then after that, you've then got to try and just guess where, or try and line it up yourself and hope that you're going to. Oh, that was lucky. But you can have a simultaneous two-player game, and I think when you destroy bubbles, I think they appear on your opponent's screen. I think this was ported. Was it ported to the SNES? Possibly. I'm not exactly sure. But it gets tough pretty damn quick. Rubbish. And you can see there the screen gradually moves towards you. Obviously what you want to try and do is aim for bits that are actually connecting other bits together, so that if you take out the main sort of connection, everything below will fall. I'm doing a bit of rubbish here. Blue, where can that go? Let's put that up top. That was a red, why did I say blue? I have no idea. Right, it's getting difficult now. Right, I'm needing a yellow. Ah, bollocks. There we go, that's game over. Yeah, that's a delightful little game. That is Puzzle Bobble. Okay, this game is called Rapid Hero. Bye, it's got a rather obscure title. Media Trading, yeah, okay. And it looks to be like some kind of shooter. And indeed it is. Now I think the largest majority of these shooter type games, especially the manga based ones, they probably never saw a release outside of Japan. The arcades were pretty much dead in their arse at this point, certainly in the UK. But I've never ever seen this game before, never even heard of it. But I never grow tired of playing games like this. Plenty of tasty blasting to be found anyway. I'm guessing that end of level guardian is about to unfold itself. There we go, it's going to come out of a large building, is it? It is indeed.
Hi,
Oh, you sod. Ah, oh, dearie me. I may actually have to try and move the next thing. Oof, that's going to be game over. It certainly is, yeah. That's Rapid Hero by Media Trading. Okay, I give you Ring of Destruction. Nope, not that type of game, it's a wrestling game. We have to give it its full Sunday name, Ring of Destruction Slam Masters 2. And this was by our favourite beat-em-up specialist, Capcom. Rasta! Oh, there's Hagar. Let's go, Hagar. He looks... Are they all out of other games? Oh, there's Jumbo. Stinger Biff. He's put the weight on since Oh, bollocks. Yeah, here's a movement. Be Biff rather than Hagar. Yeah, and just for a change, it's a beat-em-up. We've not had one of them for at least 1 minute. I mean, by this point, Capcom really, they've really honed the beat-em-up to perfection. They really couldn't do any wrong at this point. And obviously, they just kept punting out these left, right and centre because people were obviously playing them. I think it's fair to say this game was never released for any home systems. Round two, maybe some sort of flying kick that I can do when I throw him. Ouch. When I throw him against the ropes, I should be kicking him as he returns. Ooh, 3-hit combo, no less. And it's good night, Vienna. Yeah, anyway, that's actually not a bad game. That's Ring of Destruction Slam Masters 2, and that is by Capcom. Okay, this is Slapshot, and it's by Tato. Never actually heard of this game. Ah, so it's going to be a hockey-type thing. Let's go Michael Jackson. And it's Michael Jackson versus Michael Jackson. Ah, so it's not really hockey as such, it looks more like one of these air hockey games. And that's exactly what it is by the looks of things. Yeah, okay. Yeah, games like this were never going to be classics, I wouldn't have thought. Oh, a super shot. Bloody hell. Yeah, listen, you know what? That's enough of that one. That is Slapshot. Okay, do not just adjust your TV sets. This is Snow Brothers 2. Follow up to a game kind of, it was never really that popular a game, I don't think. It's Holy shit, did I just see what I thought I saw there? Some horrifically looking evil babies. Baby me. Now, the original game, similar to this, you have to actually make. Turn the baddies into snowballs. Playing the part of chimpanzee, but looking at that start screen, which will be forever placed in my memory, looks like you're playing some kind of demonic baby. This borrows a lot from Bubble Bobble, a game which I have to say isn't just a favourite of mine, I don't know why it is. Platform game of choice back in the 90s. So anyway, yeah, that's enough of that. That is Snowbrothers 2. Right, this is Space Invaders DX, which was basically released, I think, to celebrate the anniversary of the original game. Now you can see here, you actually got to choose. You could have a versus, you could have the original, or you could have a parody game mode. Which looks like that, or is that Bomb Jacks or something? Let's go for the parody one. Right, very good. Right, so you can see there, it's utilising sprites from other games. Obviously the little guy at the bottom is from the New Zealand story. And I think these... the guys are shooting, are they also from the same game? I'm not too sure. Whoops. It's an interesting idea to include this. As you can probably tell, it uses the same sound effects from the original, so it's only the graphics that have actually changed. It's a bit off-putting having the background, it's not too clear as to what you're actually trying to shoot. Let's die and take a look at the second one, or the original mode I should say. Okay, yeah, let's just go for the first one. Ah, right, so you could actually pick what version, upright, cab, black and white, black and white with cellophane, or colour. Let's just go for the upright cab. Here it is. Now I think I actually got to play one of these, this particular cab, I'm guessing mid 2000, something like 2004, 2005, something like that, and I remember being quite amazed that Space Invaders, you could still play Space Invaders, but obviously what I didn't really realise at that point was it was a re-release. So yeah, it's good old Space Invaders. So, right, I think we've seen enough of that one. Let's batter on. That was Space Invaders DX, and that was also by Taiko. Okay, this is Super Sidekicks 2 by SNK, and this was released on the Neo Geo. Obviously the sequel to Super Sidekicks 1, or Super Sidekicks as it would be called. And it always annoys me about these arcade football games, they never ever have any other British team other than England. Oh, you're all kind of Scottish, so let's go for Italy. Hey, we don't want to put anyone on. Full team. Round final. Italy versus England. This game is always, it looked nice because it kind of zooms in the action. It actually reminds me a lot like International Superstar Soccer, which came out for the SNES. And as usual, these football games, I always forget what button it is to shoot. But this was never converted for anything. I mean, it was, you could obviously, the Neo Geo was actually a system you could actually own. Penalty, come on, referee. Oh, come on. I love the exaggerated sound effects of tackles and even hitting the ball. I'm not quite sure what the fire button is actually, you know. But for an early football game, what do you say? It's actually pretty good. Ah, there you go, that was a definite stonewall penalty. Oops. Right, okay, so on occasions it cuts like any bird's eye view or a first person view. Anyway, listen, that's actually not bad, it's quite a bit of fun. That's Super Sidekicks 2, and that was by SNK. Okay, this is Super Street Fighter 2, the new challengers. Couldn't obviously miss this one out. See, at this point they had really managed to hone this game to, you know, pretty much perfection as far as, let's go for this bloke, as far as side-scrolling beat-em-ups go. Deary me! I thought I was beating him as well, but obviously not. But this was one of many iterations of Street Fighter. I mean, I don't know how many there actually were. But you know what? If people love it and it's making you money, then why not? Right, I've been absolutely humped stupid there. You know the game by now. Yep, Super Street Fighter 2, and that was by Capcom. Yes, that's what I thought as well. This is called Tattoo Assassins, and it's by Data East. The Ink of Geese is an amorphous fluid organism which can form into real objects. Holy moly, however, the ink is only compatible with those of a certain unusual genetic. Dairy God. Right, anyway, it appears to be some bizarre beat-em-up, I'm guessing. based around freaks, tattoo assassins. I actually was hoping it was going to be the little. I was just wondering it was going to be the little bloke out of Fantasy Island, but obviously not. Dear God.
I thought you could fight.
I can only apologise now if this is going to give you any nightmares. And she just spat at me. It looks like the bloke from Tron. And it's been played in slow motion. I don't believe that she is actually trying to gobbin us. She deserves to die for that. You've got to ask yourself, what were Data East thinking, releasing crap like this? I mean, seriously. It's like, it's not even like a poor man's Mortal Kombat, it's like a poor man's Mortal Kombat made in some sort of basic video game creator software. Did she just grab his balls and crush them? Tattoo assassins, dearie me. Oh dearie me. This is probably about the worst arcade game I've ever seen in my life. And if watching me playing this for a few minutes is enough to make you not want to play it, then it's been worthwhile. I think we've got to go for the final bout. Take that. And that. She's gonna spit on me.
Navy rules.
It is actually so bad it's good. In a really, really perverse sort of way. I'm actually wanting to see what comes next. One more kick to Hannah and it's lights out. No mercy. So it's a shameless rip-off of Mortal Kombat. Let's take one quick look at the next dodgy character. Ah, oh, we're fighting ourselves. Right, anyway, listen, that's enough of that one. That is probably about the worst game you're going to see today. That's the awful Tattoo Assassins by Data East. Okay, this is a bit of a legend, this one. It debuted on the PlayStation, probably. Was responsible for selling quite a few consoles. Yeah, they were converting this on the PlayStation and it was excellent. It obviously seems a bit dated now, you know, but it was absolutely staggering looking when it first appeared. Now, I never actually got to see it in arcade. In fact, I tell a lie, I did see it in arcade, but not until I owned the PlayStation 1. And I must admit, the PlayStation done a remarkable job, it really did. Looking at all these games now, you sort of think to yourself, what was all the fuss about? But, you know, we had just really moved on from sort of 16-bit games, two-dimensional games, and suddenly you were getting games like this that were kind of 3D looking, you know, and they were just amazing, amazing to play. Yep, anyway, listen, that's enough of that one, guys. That's Tekken, and that was obviously by Namco. Okay, this is Top Hunter, Roddy and Kathy. And this is on the, this was released by SNK on the Neo Geo system. The Neo Geo was certainly home to some awesome looking games. Oops, okay. Strangled or something? I don't have any idea. Guess I'm gonna try and release these guys. Why does it not want to? There we go. Ah, so I'm trying to. Wait a minute, I've just bloody saved you and you're trying to punch me. Just for that, you can piss right off. Come on, it says jump. That's what I'm trying to do, jump. That's more like it. Push it. Excuse me. Ah, we were expecting you, Mr. End of Level Guardian boss type thing. It's gonna go up, yep. Anyway, yeah, that's Top Hunter Roddy and Kathy. That was by SNK. Okay, this is Wind Jammers. This is by Data East. Now, it was released by SNK. I didn't actually realise that other companies made games for SNK. Now, I have played this before, although it was many years ago. And it's actually quite a bit of fun, if I recall. It's a bit like air hockey, but can be played side on. Trying to figure out. Right, okay. The idea being is you're also trying to get it through your opponent's goal. I think you could play two players, simultaneous two player game, or should I say, two players versus one another. Whoops. I'm getting absolutely humped again. Game over, it does appear to be. Yeah, anyway, that's Windjammers, guys. And that was released by Data East. Okay, this is X-Men Children of the Atom from Capcom, can you believe? Now, it looks rather tasty. It is, of course, another side-scrolling, not a side-scrolling beat-em-up, it's a beat-em-up, a side beat-em-up, whatever you want to call it. Let's go Wolverine. I would love to know how many people Capcom must have employed back in the 90s. I mean, there was just absolutely churning these games out like nothing on earth. But I mean, you can see the actual animation, it's gorgeous. It certainly would not look out of place in a cartoon. Beautiful looking game. Pity it's not my cup of tea, but you know, if they'd kind of come up with something different, even a sort of side-scrolling platform game with graphics like this, I'd have been in. But you know, obviously people enjoyed these games, else they wouldn't have made as many. But it's a staggeringly beautiful looking one, it really is. But I think to get any enjoyment out of these games, you've really got to learn the controls and you've got to practice. To do what I'm doing, just mashing buttons, it's just it's not a particularly enjoyable game. Let's have a quick look at this level and then we shall move on. Yeah, I mean, look at that, it looks amazing, it really does. Yeah, anyway guys, that's X-Men Children of the Atom, and that was by the mighty Capcom. Okay guys, I've saved the best to last. Probably not the best game, but the best, most complicated name. It is called Zunzukyo no Yabo. So I have got no idea what the game is. I saw this screenshot and I thought it looked interesting, so it'd be a nice wee game to finish off, so let's give it a go. Yeah, I've got no idea what this is going to be like. And alas, it's kind of... it's Galaxian! With some freaky looking... they look like these horrible little troll dolls that you used to get back in the day. What a bizarre looking game. So you've got to shoot them several times to make them actually disappear. Are these power-ups? I'm really not quite sure. No, there are that many, I'm guessing they're not power-ups. We need to continue with this. What an odd game. If anybody can tell me what's going on, please let me know. Is he giving me the finger? Yep, I think that is probably a first in video games history, especially an arcade game, somebody giving you the finger. Utterly wacky game this is. Now I challenge anybody to name a system that this particular game was converted to. There's probably some obscure Japanese system that actually had this released. But yeah, don't ask me to pronounce the name ever again. Anyway guys, listen, that is it. I keep thinking there's going to be less and less games to look at. Got to say, the majority of the games I've looked at today, they don't really float my boat. Indeed, putting these videos together is a bit of a chore because I'm not enjoying really any of them. But anyway, I want to keep on making these so we can finally put this series to bed. So anyway guys, if you've enjoyed watching it, please consider liking it. Feel free to stick down your comments, and if you want to see more videos from myself, please hit that subscribe button. I hope you enjoyed watching it guys, and as usual, thank you so much for watching.